So next we are going to discuss an important topic for NEET PG, that is esophageal perforation. So esophageal perforation, one of the high yield topic. So in esophagus, what is the most common cause of perforation? Most common cause of perforation is iatrogenic, putting an endoscopy. And most common site of perforation is in the cervical esophagus. While putting endoscopy, we injure the cervical esophagus. That is the most common site of perforation is cervical esophagus. And there are so many other causes of esophageal perforation we are going to discuss in this chapter. Apart from iatrogenic, the other causes are barotrauma. What do you mean by barotrauma? Barotrauma is also known as Borav's syndrome, also known as spontaneous rupture of esophagus. Okay, barotrauma, Borav's syndrome, or spontaneous rupture of esophagus. And the other causes are corrosive ingestion, trauma, or various other causes of esophageal perforation. In your GIT, in GIT, gastrointestinal tract, the perforation which carries highest mortality is esophageal perforation. Highest mortality is seen with esophageal perforation, especially with barotrauma. Highest mortality is seen with barotrauma causing esophageal perforation. Now the worst complications. Okay, so now let us discuss about barotrauma or Borav's syndrome. And along with Borav's syndrome, I am going to compare one another topic, that is Mallory V star. So these are two important topics I am going to put as comparison for understanding purpose. I am putting this comparison between barotrauma and Mallory V star. Now there are two guys having an alcohol on a Saturday night. They are having full alcohol. They got a champagne bottle. They are both drinking so much. And this is Mr. Ramu and this is Mr. Somu. So this is Mr. Somu and this is Mr. Ramu. They both are having so much of alcohol and consuming enormous amount of alcohol, and they both vomited. After vomiting, Ramu collapsed. His BP was scoring, pulse was scoring. He collapsed. He was very sick. And after vomiting, Somu himself walked to hospital. He himself walked to hospital with history of only hematemesis. He himself walked to hospital. So now what happened to Ramu and Somu? So please understand the pathophysiology behind this two conditions. So this is the esophagus, and when this is stomach containing chicken peas, alcohol, everything inside. And when Ramu vomited, everything came out. When Ramu vomited, everything came out, but his glottis does not open up. So in Ramu, glottis is tightly closed. It does not open up. So the food particles, they all ruptured into the left side of the chest. The most common site of perforation in Borav's syndrome is lower left posterior esophagus. Lower left posterior esophagus is the most common site of rupture of esophagus in Borav's syndrome. Please don't forget this. Most common site of rupture is lower left posterior. The contents all entered into the left side thoracic cavity. All this is because of the closed glottis that does not open, so it reflexed and the contents all ruptured into the left side chest. On the other hand, in Mallory V star, what happened to Somu? In Somu, the OG junction, the LES, OG junction is closed while he is vomiting. So while he is vomiting, the OG junction is closed. So it created a tear. Most common site of tear. It is not a full thickness tear. It is a partial tear involving mucosa and submucosa only. There is a tear involving mucosa and submucosa only. The most common site is below OG junction at lesser curve. At lesser curve part of cardia. This is the place at cardia. So the most common site of Tear in Mallory Weiss tear is below OG junction at lesser curve near cardia is the site of tear here. This is the place of tear. So the patient developed tear on the lesser curvature side below OG junction. Please remember this point. So why there is a Borel syndrome in Ramu? In Ramu, glottis is closed. In Somu, LES is tightly closed. So Ramu developed full thickness rupture of lower left posterior part of esophagus. Somu developed tear in the lesser curvature side at cardia part. Please don't forget this point. And therefore, since there is a full thickness tear in Borel syndrome, patient develops a triad known as Mackler's triad. What is Mackler's triad? Mackler's triad is characterized by vomiting, followed by chest pain, followed by subcutaneous emphysema. This is known as Mackler's triad. Vomiting, chest pain, subcutaneous emphysema is known as Mackler's triad. Please don't forget Mackler's triad and Borel syndrome. And this fellow is only characterized, Somu is only characterized by hematemesis, and 90% of the time this hematemesis stops by itself. 90% of the time it stops by itself. The bleeding stops in 90% of the time. The bleeding stops by itself. Therefore, only 10% of them will need intervention. Need intervention by endoscopy. Endoscopic coagulation is done for those 10% of the patients. So 90% of the time the bleeding stops by itself. Only 10% of them needs endoscopic coagulation. Please don't forget, 10% of them will need endoscopic coagulation. So this is very important point, you should not forget in exam. And Borel syndrome patient will become very sick. They will be in mediastinitis. They are in mediastinitis. If you are not going to manage them, most of them will die. So immediately shift them to theater, and the golden period for surgery is within 24 hours we have to do thoracotomy. Within thoracotomy should be done in 24 hours, open the thorax, reach the perforation area and close the perforation and keep an ICD and come out. So 24 hours is the golden period for Borel syndrome. If you have extended beyond 24 hours, it has extended beyond 24 hours, we should again operate only. We have to operate and you have to go to the site of rupture. If the tissue is healthy, you repair. If tissue is healthy, you can repair. If the tissue is unhealthy, you have to do the following procedure. The esophagus should be drained out, known as esophagostomy. And you have to put an ICD, known as thoracostomy. And you have to do a feeding jejunostomy. And you have to do a feeding jejunostomy for this patient. So a patient who comes to you with the esophageal perforation, within 24 hours the tissue, ruptured tissue will be healthy, we can do a primary repair. If he comes after 24 hours, even after 24 hours, if the tissue is healthy, we can do primary repair. But if the tissue is unhealthy, we have to debride the tissues and we have to do esophagostomy, thoracostomy and feeding jejunostomy for those patients. So please don't forget Borel syndrome and Mallory Weiss tear. So this high yield MCQ for your exam, Borel syndrome and Mallory Weiss tear. So this is the two important topic for esophageal perforation. And on another day, so this is the sign which I told you. What is the name of this sign? This sign is known as Necklerio V sign. Necklerio V sign.